The strength of every relationship is the amount of freedom in it. The more freedom there is in a relationship, that much detachment we have. So detachment is a byproduct of the freedom that we allow to people. So ownership, possessiveness, you know, trying to bind people, selfishly trying to own people, these are all against detachment. And what is for detachment is the freedom. The biggest gift I can give you is freedom from myself, even myself. That means you don't have any obligation to be with me or not to be with me. That means this friendship can remain forever. But when I expect something from you, I'm binding you. When I bind you, freedom is lost. The cost is freedom. So when freedom is lost, the relationship suffers. This you can see in marital relationships also. Sometimes big time possessiveness and it destroys the relationship. Then they do bizarre things. Have we ever thought why people go and do things which are totally strange and bizarre? That's because something is missing. They're trying to acquire something which they don't have, especially freedom. So if you really, really want a good relationship with anybody, father, mother, husband, wife, children, a master, disciple, what you name it, any relationship, take anything. If you put a lot of freedom into that relationship as the main ingredient, like we, or right amount of freedom, like we put salt or sugar in certain dishes, you know, that really changes the flavor. Like that, if you put freedom into any relationship, it'll be beautiful. It will remain forever. And then it's a flow. Do not try to put boundaries to any relationship. See, I'm not a spiritual teacher, or I'm not only a humanitarian, or I mean, you can't say that I'm one thing. I'm many things. We all are many things. We all have numerous dimensions. And each dimension has perfection. And each dimension needs freedom in it, freedom of expression. But I say, okay, you do whatever you want, but don't do this. That means you are restricted. And especially whatever we say as taboo, they want to do it. That sells more. Have you seen the world, how it operates? People who have been prohibited of doing something, that's exactly what sells more. We were like that, right? When we were children, when somebody says, oh no, you can't do that. We want to do that. We will do that. Because then it becomes a challenge. That's the only thing in the mind, right? You're only thinking about, oh, I want to do that. I want to do that. This is not allowed, or this is taboo. I must do it. Whether you like it or not, whether you want it or not, that's not the point here. The point is that break the boundary. So we are like this. So what is detachment here? Detachment is the amount of freedom that you put into anything. And freedom, the ultimate freedom, is not freedom of mind or intellect or ego or senses. Senses cannot function by itself without these faculties, these processors. So freedom is actually freedom from all this. Freedom from all this. That means you're not bound by mind. You're not bound by senses or anything. You are free to be you. And the choice of, one of the ultimate choices of freedom is to be silent. If you don't have to talk, you don't talk. Means there is no pressure for performing. This is freedom. But that's not a depression, you know, that's not tamas. I'm not talking about tamas. Tamas means you have no energy to perform. That's not what I mean. You have all the energy, you have all the motivation, but you don't have to do something if it is not your cup of tea. Freedom. Most of us live for the sake of somebody. Somebody said you have to be like that, and we just go like a machine. And end of the day, there is no satisfaction, no contentment. Even if you have one day fully contented, that's worth a lifetime of passive existence. You know, but we, unfortunately, we have passive existence for a long period of time. And we sometimes don't even think about it. You see? So this is exactly the point. Detachment is freedom. And detachment is not indifference. These are all insignificant. We are not pushing somebody away or taking something off your menu. That's not detachment. When you don't want something, like for example, like somebody gives me a very expensive alcohol, I wouldn't drink because I don't need it. I have overcome that desire for alcohol. So I don't really have any inclination or tendency for alcohol or any intoxication for that matter. I'm intoxicated already, you know, with God. So I don't really need an external intoxication to dull me. I would rather have the ecstasy inside. So this is what I'm saying, detachment. Detachment means you don't need it. Not that I love this alcohol, but I'm Mohanji, so I can't drink. Not that. That means suppression. That is suppression. Suppression of a desire that is not gone from your system. It stays there. You know, when it stays there, it'll ask for a manifestation at some point in time. You see? So that's not detachment. Detachment is something drops off. And that, to drop off, you need a lot of freedom to do that. Freedom means totally liberated, right? You're liberated. You're liberated from yourself. You give that freedom to every relationship. And it's so beautiful. Then there is no guilt. There is no regret. There is no anger. There is no expectation. You know, so many things are taken care of, right? This is also the truth of human existence. See, what will I do by binding you to me? Mm-hmm. If I bind you, what am I expressing? Insecurity. You know, how do you know that I am free from inside? If I display lesser insecurity, that means I am more connected to myself. See, being secure is a clear sign of balance or balance of life. There's nothing to worry. Like you said in the beginning, the flexibility. You know, we were not planning to talk on this platform today, but it happened and you suddenly improvised yourself and you did it. That's the flexibility. That is how life works. Life gives you that opportunity to be flexible. And if you are flexible, we don't have pains. If we don't have flexibility, we have regrets, pains, guilt, so many other factors. Anything can happen because, oh, I wanted to do that, but I couldn't do it. So it's not good. So life is like that. How much flexible you are, how much secure you are. Secure means you are fine with yourself. And anybody coming to you, you embrace them because they are all part of you. Then anybody is not coming to you also, you have no anger towards them. You love them. So there, the whole connection is linked by freedom. You know, you're welcome. But if you don't come, don't think that you are offending me. Something like that. Something like that. There's no offense here. There's only freedom. So you're always welcome. You're related to me. You will always be related to me, whether we meet or not. And you're not obligated to do something to stay in this relationship. This is the problem with most of the relationships of the world.
Yeah.
You know, there is an expectation and a corresponding obligation. If you don't perform that, you are unwanted or you are not liked. You are disliked. So in this mode, there is nothing like it. There's no dislike. You cannot dislike anybody because we are made of love. You know, we are love incarnates. And we are indeed a refined species. We are human beings. And human beings are born free. All beings are born free, but many of them do not know this. But we know this. We are born free and we will die free. And in between all that's happening, all the relationship, all this kind of emotions and things happening, they all have temporary state. They all are here only for some time. You cannot have them all the time. Like waves, they come and go. So our path and journey itself is this realization from the binding aspects to a total freedom. So this is the movement. binding to freedom. You know, binding is binding by the mind. Freedom, freedom in everything. Free from ourselves. So that my expectations itself is my binding. If I don't have much expectation, freedom. I only look at it this way. If somebody comes to me, I make sure I don't leave them empty-handed. This is the way I think normally. It's not that I can do that every time. Sometimes it's not, it doesn't work. But I try. I try to fill them up for, or at least empower them. I would rather use the word empower. So that they are going back slightly better, at least 5% better than when they came in. Same, I think that when somebody is talking to me, they are spending their time in my presence. So they should be, there should be some improvement in their life. Not every time it happens, because it's not like a clockwork, but possible. I try. When a person loves you, it doesn't matter whether they come and meet you. The main thing is that, do you live in somebody's heart and do somebody live in your heart? This is the bottom line. So if there is no chance of meeting now with this COVID situation, many trips are canceled. We can't meet people. That's okay. That's fine. But do we live in each other's heart? That makes the difference. And that adds the value to life, right? What is life for? Having beautiful friendships, beautiful relationships, and without obligation, without any give and take, unconditional. That's the beauty of existence. That's a sign of refinement. Not that we have tons of expectations, and if none of these are fulfilled or some of these are not fulfilled, we have problem or we are angry. That's not good relationship. That's a big time binding. You know, like we see that, oh, you must go to this temple. If you don't go to the temple, you'll have a curse. Do you think that God is sitting there to curse anybody? You know, these are all here. This is our imagination. Nobody will curse you for not meeting them if they are fully secure. If they are insecure, they will need you all the time. It's like some child need attention of the parents all the time because they feel very insecure if there is no attention. There are adults also like that. They need attention. They do something to there are certain stories like that, right? All the time they're craving for attention, and they create some scene so that people are attending to them. Many people fall sick because of that. You know, they feign sickness, or they like to be sick so that they get the attention. Yeah. You know, so but a secure person chooses to be healthy so that there is no binding for anybody. And even if there is an ailment, they can take care of themselves. So we got to be free, really, really free, you know, liberated fully from ourselves and our expectations and bindings and all these things. That makes us literally a total human being. You see, this is very important. And as I said, you know, why do we go to places like Kailas? It destroys your comfort zones. There's nothing proper. The space is the high altitude, lack of oxygen. So many things are not in our favor. And when we destroy these comfort zones, we remold ourselves. With every destruction, there is a remolding. You know, so I always feel that when somebody comes to me, I like to remold them to something better so that their life becomes easier. And how do you know that you have remolded? When your life becomes, your outlook changes, your life becomes easier. You see things with more clarity. But otherwise, it's prejudiced view, right? We are looking through a certain concept, certain prejudices, certain things which we have collected, acquired from the society. And that's how we see the world. But here, we take this whole thing off. And then we look at it. Then what you see is clear. We know truth as truth. So this is the reason why I always believe that the highest gift you can ever give to anybody is freedom, even from ourselves.